terminal cleaners, use some sort of spray cleaner. Once you've cleaned it up, don't just leave that lead out there to be exposed to the acid that's on the top of the battery. Put some sort of spray cleaner on it. If you don't have that, you can buy those little red and green rings that go on there. The purpose of those rings is to absorb the acid before it attacks the lead and turns it into lead sulfate. Use some sort of spray. I've had people that say, I just once a month take WD-40 and spray my terminals. It works. If you don't have anything else, put grease on there. All you're trying to do is push the acid away from the terminal and protect that terminal from acid getting on it. When acid gets on the lead, it reacts and it becomes lead sulfate, and they corrode with that white mushroomy looking stuff. And it's the acid attacking it. And the more you clean it, the more it's going to attack it. So you just need to protect it. Put some sort of spray on it. Tighten the terminals. I know so many people that take their battery terminals and they just kind of wiggle them on and they leave them loose because I got to take them back off sometime. I'm always charging the battery. I'm always doing something. And so they just leave them loose. If they're loose, you don't have very good contact. When I'm cranking and I'm drawing that tremendous amount of amperage, it causes it to arc. It ruins your post. And if it arcs and this battery has hydrogen gas around it, it could blow up. Even if you're not around it, if it arcs, it could blow up. So it's a safety reason. Make sure you tighten those terminals and keep them tight. Prepare the hold downs. Every battery is designed to have a hold down somewhere, either down the bottom, a strap, a bar, something. Don't over tighten the hold downs because you'll break the case. And so you got the extremes that everyone has. So they crank it way down until it bulges out and damages it, or they just don't put them on at all. So use a clamp puller. It's another one of those specialty tools. This is the clamp puller. You got a battery cable that's on here, it's clamped down really tight, you loosen it up and it won't come off. So what does everybody do? You take a screwdriver and you put it underneath it and you pry it up, and when you do that, it pulls the post right out of the battery. And if you look inside of here, there's not much holding that thing, and so you actually pull the post right out. Or you take a screwdriver and you wiggle it, and you put it in there, jam it, and twist it around. You can scratch it up and tear it. If you don't have one of these, then putting a screwdriver between where the bolt is and twisting it will actually pry it open, and that actually is a fun. That's good. It's better than any other thing you have. Otherwise, if you just grab the battery cable and twist it, it's the same as lifting up on it. You actually turn the whole post and will break it off internally down below. So you don't want to do that. This tool, what it does is it goes over the battery post, it reaches down underneath, it grabs the bottom of the cable, and the centerpiece, when you screw on it, it pushes on the post and pulls up on the cable. So you're not actually pulling the cable out or twisting it, you're actually just holding the post and pulling up on the cable. And it will not damage the post. And so they're not very expensive, so you should get one. If not, use a screwdriver and pry it apart. Just twist the screwdriver and open the end of it up so you can just set it off. If you can't just lift it off, then there's a chance that you're going to damage that post.